সুপ্রিয় দর্শক, বিরতির পর আপনাদের সবাইকে আবারও আমন্ত্রণ কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্সে। আজকে আমরা কথা বলছি টাওয়ার হ্যামলেটসের এক্সিকিউটিভ মেয়র মেয়র জন বিক্সের সাথে। আমরা ফার্স্ট সেগমেন্টে জন বলছিল যে গত 30 বছরের উপর অ্যাজ এ লোকাল রেসিডেন্ট হোয়াট সর্ট অফ চেঞ্জেস হি হ্যাজ সিন অ্যাট ইস্ট লন্ডন, পার্টিকুলারলি ইন টাওয়ার হ্যামলেটস, এবং আরও বলছিল যে টাওয়ার হ্যামলেটসের যে বিভিন্ন অপরচুনিটিস এবং চ্যালেঞ্জেসগুলো টু রান দ্য কাউন্সিল, হাউজিং হাউজিং ইস্যু বলছিল, কোয়ালিটি অফ লাইফ বলছিল, এডুকেশন বলছিল, তারপরে আরও বিভিন্ন কমিউনিটি সেফটি এবং ইয়াংদেরকে কীভাবে আরও ইনভলভ করা যায়, ইয়াংদের জন্য কী সুযোগ সুবিধা ক্রিয়েট করা যায়, এইসব ব্যাপারে কিন্তু জন বিক্স ফোকাস করছিল। তো আমরা জন, থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ ওয়ান্স অ্যাগেন ফর জয়নিং আস টুডে অ্যাট এনটিভি ইউরোপ। অন ইউর ওপেনিং স্টেটমেন্ট ইউ ইউ মেনশন ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট changes that you have seen over the time, and you mentioned two three positive changes that you have seen, particularly moving away from the racism that early Bangladeshis they faced, particularly in Tower Hamlets, and then the growth in certain part of Tower Hamlets, as for example Isle of Dogs, Canary Wharf area. You mentioned those as well. Housing crisis is a big crisis, not only in Tower Hamlets but in any part of UK. We often anytime we open television or you know, newspaper, we see that housing crisis is coming everywhere. You know, in every major political parties, housing crisis,
Absolutely.
NHS, these are the significant part of their election manifesto. You, as a mayor of Tower Hamlets, what you have done to you know, to face this particular challenge? Number one. Number two is, do you think there is enough budget, enough support from the central government for the councils like yours to tackle this problem?
One of the great things about London and British cities in general, but London has always been that we have mixed communities. So you don't just have areas where rich people live and then far, far away areas where poor people live. We've always had mixed communities in London. And there's a problem now, which is the lack of funding for affordable housing means that Tower Hamlets, although it started, it's still got a lot of relatively poor people in it, is becoming less and less affordable by the day. And what I think we need, I'm not here to do party politics, but I'm pretty clear, I'm a Labour politician, and I want us to have a government that funds more affordable housing. So I don't mind people becoming successful with their businesses, building homes which they can sell to people, but we need to also provide homes
affordable.
That people can afford to live in.
Right.
And we just don't have the funding to do that. The government doesn't give us the funding to do that. Even if you're a charitable housing association, you can only build homes by building some for sale to help pay for the ones that you rent out. And
right.
That's just tragic. It means that every week at my surgery, I see families who just cannot, don't know where they're going to be living the next year. They may be in temporary accommodation. They may be 15 miles away from Tower Hamlets. I want to build homes in our borough for them, and I can't do enough of that. We can do some, so we're making some progress. So we need more money. Yeah, I mean, it's politicians always say they need more money, but we do need more money from government. I think the government's got a duty to keep London going. To keep London going, we need to have people at all levels in their lives living within our
city.
Otherwise,
it will be a very racially
segregated
city.
Yeah. So if I turn up at the town hall at 7 a.m, I get to my office early, and the cleaning staff are there, and most of them live in places like Dagenham now.
Right.
So they come
because
in, they
can
in, they
no
cannot
longer
afford to live in inner East London. So
right.
There are still some who live in East London, but they come in on the bus, 45, 50 minutes, and they can do it, but it's no way to run your life. You've got to
right.
get your kids to school. We need to have more balanced communities.
Right.
So what I also need to do, and I do this with my cabinet, with my councillors, the whole council, across the different parties, hopefully we work together, is to keep telling the government that if they want Tower Hamlets to do the great job it does for this country, because it is a fantastic place, then they need to invest in it. And just to be clear about that, and this is true of the British Bengali community as it is of all other communities that have come to the East End, people come to East London because they want to make a success of their lives, and they can do that. But helping that to happen requires us to invest in education and in housing and making sure people have a good basic quality of life so they can then make their own way. And if we stop doing that, then the magic of East London and the success it brings to our country will stop.
Right. But for the last, more than 3 years, mm-hmm. you as a mayor, yep. was housing
okay.
your priority. I mean, do you think you have done enough to tackle these issues? Because there are criticisms okay. in
yeah.
place
okay.
that council is not doing enough to.
No, the council can. Well, I suppose I'm a very self-critical person. I think the council can never do enough. So, however much I build, I will want to build twice as much, three times as much. We have seen more affordable housing built in town in the last 3 years than there were in each of the years before that. So under the new mayor, we're doing more. Some of that's because of the way the market works. Some of it's because we're being cleverer at the way we spend the money.
Right.
I appointed a commission of people, some independent people, to look at affordable housing, because I think a lot of people are very cynical about affordable housing. The government's got a policy on affordability, which is really not affordable for many people. You mm-hmm. know, you're told, here's an affordable home. Do you want to rent it? And it's £250 a week. And you can't do that on a low wage. So.
Right.
So we pushed the rental levels down as well, because we want people to be able to live in places that they genuinely can afford. We've released some land. We don't have much land left, but we're looking at land that we can provide at low cost or free even to housing associations or for the council to build council houses on. We're using some of our reserves to buy council houses back from private landlords for our temporary households. So we're doing a whole number of things. Are we doing enough? No, I want to do a lot more. And I need help from other people, including the government, to do that. But,
right.
but we made a real step in the right direction.
But a few of the, few of the social housing organization, those are supposed to run as a charity or not a profit-driven organization,
yeah.
there are critics in place that those organizations, they are running that particular organization being too mm. much commercial focused.
Yep.
They're not looking after the working people. Mm. So what they're supposed to be social housing, rather they are becoming some sort of very expensive housing state. What do you make of it?
Well, I agree with that criticism, because I think if I'm a housing association and I'm a charity, my absolute job has got to be to provide affordable housing for people on lower incomes, and it's not to be a property developer. The housing associations would say that they are being forced by the government policy to build places for sale in order to subsidize the places for rent. But what that means is a terrible waste of resources. What we need is to invest in our housing associations as well as the councils to provide affordable homes. And without doing that, we're just going to be letting people down. So I think that they have limited choice on that. If they
right.
want to build homes for rent, they have to build homes for sale to help pay for that. But that's not what they're there for.
Can council not step into this matter
and hold those
okay. organizations into account, saying that you mm-hmm. are there to look after people, you are social housing organization,
yep.
but why you are driven by commercial interest?
Well,
why are you forcing people out of Tower Hamlets?
We can do some of that, and we do complain to them. We refuse some of their planning applications. We force them to have more affordable housing. Sometimes they appeal to the government and jump over us, but we strike a hard bargain with them.
Right.
But the government has weakened their regulations so that we can't force them. And so I want a government in this country that gives greater power to force housing associations to build places for rent at low rent, and also gives them the money to do that. And another part of this then is my council could borrow quite a lot more money at very low interest rates to help build housing, but the government currently says that they won't let us do that. So this
right.
this is a problem. So there's lots we need to do. I suppose I could say another thing. I know I'm very passionate about this, that we in Tower Hamlets now, another big change is now 4 out of 10 homes, 40% of homes are private rented homes. They might be in ex-council flats, or they might be in new housing schemes where people have bought them as investments. And we need to regulate that better as well, because the rents in those properties and the way that some of those landlords behave is very bad as well.
Right. There are some tough landlords,
yep.
those who are they are trying to be tough on their tenants,
but
which is
yeah.
not very good, is
so
it?
So one of the big problems we have nowadays in Tower Hamlets, and this is less true for families, but it's true for younger people, is that a landlord will have a 3-bedroom flat and they will rent the rooms one at a time. So you have a separate contract for each room. Sometimes they turn the
right.
living room into
right.
another bedroom, so you have a 3-bedroom flat with 4 separate people in it who don't know each other.
Right.
It's overcrowded. The landlord makes
it's not very healthy.
The
either,
landlord makes a lot of money, and I appreciate that people want to make money out of their investments.
Right.
But in terms of a sustainable future for our community,
it's not very good.
It's not the way I want to see it happen long term.
Right. Well, John, in Tower Hamlets particularly, you know, we have, as you mentioned, that there are so many changes that you have seen being a local resident. Canary Wharf, which is the business hub of the whole world, if I may say so. And we have also seen that Crossrail is crossing through Tower Hamlets, you know, and we have seen there are so many regeneration projects coming to Tower Hamlets. As for example, Crisp Street Market is another big example that we have seen recently in local newspaper and also on our TV channels and other TV channels as well. These sort of regeneration projects, they are just serving few of the big cash. They are not serving the local people. What do you make of it?
So if you were to go up into a spaceship and look down on Tower Hamlets, you would see, and you looked at the passage of time, you will see that what used to be a very poor borough with cheap land is turning into a quite a wealthy...
Have you done that? Have you been to Switch?
Yeah, let's pretend I have. And you can, but I've been here long enough to see the change.
No, absolutely.
And so, you know, like I said, you used to be able to buy a house for less than £100,000. Now you can't buy one for less than £600,000, you know, the same house. And so clearly something's happening with the way the market works.
Right.
And my job as mayor is I can't solve that, but it is to smooth that, to reduce the impact of that, and to try to make the case again and again and again that if we're going to support the whole community in the East End, then we need to regulate that more toughly than we're able to do at the moment. So so we're doing what we can, and we need to do more, and we need the government to change its policy.
Right.
We need, I mean, in the end, we need to build more housing across the whole of London.
No, absolutely.
So you talk about Crossrail.
Right.
What Crossrail would do, although the fares will be high, it will mean that more people who live in the Thames Valley or out in Essex will be able to get to work in central London in a reasonable travel time. They'll have to pay a high fare to do that. So that will help, but it ain't the whole solution.
Right, absolutely. John, these sort of regeneration projects, it definitely, it changes the area, you know, it creates job opportunities as well. These are the positive side about it. Do you think this sort of regeneration project create job for local people as well, particularly for young people? As for example, as I just mentioned few minutes back about Canary Wharf, do you think Canary Wharf, but or that particular organization that operate in Canary Wharf area, those organizations, they are creating enough job opportunities or even for internship for local young people?
Right. Well, I think that an increasing number, in fact, most of the employers at Canary Wharf recognize that it doesn't matter what their workforce looks like. They want people who can do the job effectively.
Right.
And if you go down there, you'll find the workforce is becoming more representative, but it's not happening as quickly as it should do. So I run the council. The council has a workforce which is very representative of the local community. We made a point of recruiting people regardless of who they are. We don't recruit people who look like us. We recruit people who represent the whole community, and as a result of that, we have a very representative workforce. Employers at Canary Wharf need to do more about that,
right.
And it's in their own interest. You know, people who live nearby and can get to work on time, a pretty good thing. The Canary Wharf companies trade across the whole world. People have a diverse experience of the world, a pretty good thing as well.
Absolutely.
So we need to get the employers to change. We also need to get local people's confidence and employability to improve as well. So some people,
where council can step in and provide this sort of training.
We can work with employers, we can work with training agencies, we can give people good career advice, you know, all those things that help to make sure that when people like you and me leave school and we go to college, we have in our minds some idea of how we can, you know,
absolutely
make the next step.
But John, don't you think that you as an executive mayor or your cabinet or your council can make some sort of partnership with those organizations, saying that, look, you know, you have to take certain people, those who are living in local area, even as an intern, so that they can build that sort of confidence or practical experience, so that they can, in near future, they can contribute.
I think we make a good double act, because you're absolutely right, and that's what we have to do, and that's what we are doing. We have something called the Tower Hamlets Partnership, where we work with employers, trainers, ourselves, the health service. Across the board, we have a partnership board that looks at the wider community and how we can support each other.
Right.
It includes private sector employers, and we need to push them, and they want to do this. Some of them don't know how to do it, and yeah, we need to make those connections.
How this project is going?
We're doing a lot of that, but we need to do more still.
Right.
So we need to get work placements. You always hear from employers about how they gave some work experience and some young kids from town which came along and they didn't know how to behave. You always hear the bad stories, but for every bad story, there's a lot of good stories as well.
Right.
And if you look at the success stories behind the East End, you'll find, just looking at the Bengali community, the Bangladeshi community in East London, people are moving to East Ham and Redbridge and Barking to the, you know, nicer houses, and they're buying a place. And that's on the back of the success that young people are having in getting into work and making
Right.
a living. It's also, by the way, because a lot of people within the community are good at setting up their own businesses as
Thank
well.
you. Thank you very much, John. We'll talk more about it. Shubhpriyo darshok, ajke community matters e amra kotha bolchi Tower Hamlets er executive mayor John Wicks er sathe. Amra jabo ekta birotite, amader sathei thakben.